Hi guys, welcome to the CET Daily Series. Today we are going to be talking about a topic called as data sufficiency, which is actually a very easy to score and a, you know, least time consuming section, but people end up doing a lot of mistakes because they've never practiced, never studied it. It becomes, you know, out of the blue when they see it in the mock test or in the actual exam. So let's make sure we make this as one of your strengths. And trust me, after 5 minutes of watching this video, even you will be assured that, you know, yeah, actually data sufficiency is easy and we must get as many questions as we can in the exam for the same. More or less, usually somewhere around 5 to 10 questions come from this section of data sufficiency. So let's understand more of this with the help of example questions, because the best part is you actually did not solve these questions. You don't have to get to the answers. You just have to tell me whether the information is enough or not. That's it. So it's, you know, less time consuming. You would take nearly around 15 seconds per question and not more than that. Okay, so let's understand the first question. Now, the important aspect which you have to keep in mind is that your answer options which are there, okay, the options remains the same throughout all of them, okay. So if I look at these options, you have option A, which says only statement 1 is sufficient, okay. Option B, which says only statement 2 is sufficient. Option C, which says either statement 1 or statement 2. And the fourth option is neither of the statements are sufficient. And the last one is that both are required together. Okay. So you have to see that these options are going to remain the same throughout your questions. Now, each question, understand and see whether the statement is enough or not. Okay. So let's take the first one. The first question says, what are the values of X and Y? The statement given to me is X is an odd integer, Y is an even integer, and X is greater than Y. So I could have like n number of numbers coming in this category. If I say X is 5, Y could be something like 2, 4, any of it, right? So only one is not enough. So if only one is not enough, then in that case, definitely we are not going to have, you know, one is not enough. So A cannot be my answer and C can also not be my answer. So I'm left with B, D and E as option, okay? Now let's look at the next statement, which says product of X and Y is 30. If I write the product of X and Y, I have four options: 15 and 2, 5 and 6, 3 and 10, 1 and 30. So again, 2 alone is not enough. So B is also ruled out. Now let me see if I combine the two statements, whether I get the answer or not. From these two, I know four options. If I say X is an odd integer, okay, yes, X is an odd integer in all of them. Y is even, okay, Y is even in all of them, and X is greater than Y. If X is greater than Y, that fits in only in one category, which is 15 and 2. So if both the statements are considered, yes, I'm getting my answer. So the answer option is E. Both of them are sufficient and are required together to solve the question. So that means I can just read the questions, and I did to understand that on the basis to make you understand more where it should be going. But it did not take much time. Okay, so that's how these questions are. Let's take a few more example questions to understand the same. Okay, this is a very interesting question. You get a lot of time questions based on age factor. Okay, so now here the question is Raj older than Karan? Okay, now from my first statement, I know Priya is 4 years elder to Raj and she is 2 years. Sorry, it's given Priya is 4 years younger than Raj and 2 years younger than Karan. So that means Priya's age plus 4 years gives you Raj's age and Priya's age plus 2 years gives you Karan's age. So definitely Raj is elder than Karan. Yes. So statement one is sufficient. So A can be the answer. Let's look at the second statement, which says the average age of Raj and Karan is 17 years. Just basis of the average, I can't say who's elder. So 2 is not sufficient. That means my answer is A, only statement 1 is sufficient. Okay, it didn't take more than, it just took 30 seconds to do it. When you start getting a hang of it in the exam, you don't have to explain it to anybody. You'll be done in 10 to 15 seconds. Okay, so let's make sure we save our time doing these data sufficiency questions. Alright, so let's come to the next question, which is what is the speed of the train A in kilometers per hour? Okay. The first statement given to me is length of the train A is twice that of train B, and the speed of train B is 100 meter per second. Just by knowing the two ka length ratio and one speed, can I know the speed of the other? No. So A cannot be the answer, C cannot be the answer. Second statement, the train A crosses B in 10 seconds. Length of the train B is 100 meter. Now I know the difference of time between that crossing of them. I know the length of train B. I know the length. So with only this, I can alone cannot be done. So now knowing both of them together, can you get the answer? You'll have two equations, right? Ideally, having two equations and two variables, it's easy to find. But in this case, it's not. You have to be very careful because you have to make sure your concepts are very clear. If you look at the statements, they have not mentioned in which direction are the trains traveling. Are they traveling in the same direction or opposite direction? So that's very important. It's a fundamental thing which is missing in the statements. So if the minute you realize that they have not spoken about directions, you need not delve into it. Directly your answer becomes D. Neither of the statements are enough because it cannot be determined. Okay, so be very sure of your fundamentals. Trust me, data sufficiency questions are going to be no-brainers, very easy, provided your fundamentals of maths are clear. Okay, so just make sure you revise all your basic books, formulas, and go before the exam for sure. Okay, let's take one more last example to understand this concept. Okay, so this is based on your cost price and selling price of profit and loss basically. So what is the cost price of the article? After selling the article, a loss of 20% was incurred on the cost price. Just by knowing the percentage of loss, can I get the cost price? No, so A cannot be the answer. The selling price is 4/5 of the cost price. Now, I know the ratio between the two. From this, can I get the absolute value of cost price? No, so A, B and C are ruled out. Now, if I combine the two statements, yes, I have two equations with two variables and we can solve them simultaneously and get the answer. Yes, so that means the answer is E. Yes, both statements 1 and 2 are sufficient and are required together. I don't have to find the cost price. I just have to tell you whether the statements can give me the answer or not. That's it. Okay, so this is what is data sufficiency, which is very easy to score, very time, you know, saving your time because it does not consume a lot of time. So you can use that time in probably the data interpretation questions or RCE questions, which are very lengthy. All right, so make sure you definitely attempt these 5 to 10 questions and score them correct for sure. Make sure you guys are doing it. Okay, great. So I hope this entire session of the past 5 to 10 minutes has helped you in understand what data sufficiency is and how you can score in that. I hope you all are enjoying the entire CET daily series. Please subscribe to the channel and make sure you don't miss out any of the videos from this series, because we'll be covering up all the aspects, right from your verbal to logical reasoning, quants, data interpretation, visual reasoning. Everything will be discussed, right into understanding how to give the marks, everything. So make sure you do not miss out any of these videos. If this is the first video you guys have seen, so please cover up the last previous entire 10 days videos which has been done for your verbal and strategies, and ensure you guys are doing really well in CET. Would love to see you guys making it to JBIMS. In fact, to increase your practice, we have also started the daily CET sprint on Facebook. Just join the Target JBIMS Avengers group and every day 9 p.m. solve topic wise questions. Keep practicing, keep enjoying, keep studying and do well. If you guys are still not sure which mocks and how to go ahead, you can check out the CATKing mocks and go ahead with that. All right, all the best, do well and make it to JBIMS.